we gonna dedicate this to you. Donovan Sadiq, this is Rehab Radio. Welcome to the show, you guys. I know it's been a little bit since I've been, doing the actual podcast, but I am still doing it. I'm actually doing it, doing the best that I can. A lot of stuff going on in my personal life, loved ones. It's after Christmas. It's the new year. A lot of stuff is going on. I mean, life goes on regardless of, what we think is going on. I mean, even if you are retired, you still got things that are actually happening. But if you guys have been paying attention, please do me a favor real quick. We are pushing the African Diaspora News Channel app. You can get that over at the Apple Store as well as Google Play. Go ahead and download that app because it is a way to communicate and see what is going on in the African diaspora around the world. You've got contributors like Vicky Dillard, Juan Gale, Demetra K, Brother Phil Scott. They have like two or three new people on there. So this app is really, really good. I actually use this app to stay abreast of what is going on in the African diaspora, not only here in the United States, but also overseas. So I strongly, strongly recommend you guys do that. The revolution will not be televised. You guys understand that? The revolution is not going to be televised. So it's an app where we can talk about issues that concern us. You got these Boule Negroes running around here that are listening to us in the New Black Media on YouTube, and they are taking our points and trying to manipulate it in a way to where it means one thing to us and it means something to them, and they're circumventing our messages. So we could go on this platform, speak the way we want to speak, and without being censored. So please go ahead and look, download the African Diaspora News Channel app, become a member. It doesn't cost a lot of money. I mean, come on, some of you guys spend $10 a day just going to Starbucks, $80 a week, on your weed habit and stuff like that. Just take a thing and get, if it's a money thing, take the full year membership. Why not? Right? That way you ain't got to worry about it. So anyway, if you guys have been watching and paying attention, Joe Biden decides to go down to South Carolina with Jimbo Clyburn, and he wants to use the old civil rights playbook of showing up in a church and, talking madness to Black people, because it works. It works for the older Black people. And, personally, I was so ashamed to see these older Black civil rights people, people that fought in the civil rights and the silent generation, sitting there applauding this man when they see what is happening to this country right now. I mean, it's an outright disgrace. What is going on? But yet, our elders don't give a damn. They don't give a damn about the next generation. And again, if it doesn't apply, let it on by. Only a hit dog hollers. So I don't talk about everybody. Of course, any intelligent person knows it's not an everybody thing, okay? If it doesn't apply to you, just let it on by. I'm not talking about you, but you guys know who we're talking about. The Boule, all this other stuff. How many times have I told you guys, we have plenty of Black people in positions to change the lives of Black people in this country? Most of your major police departments are run by Black police chiefs. Has the police culture in the United States changed? Absolutely not, because the sovereign citizen is the police department. When you guys talk about sovereign citizens, for those of you guys that don't know, sovereign citizens are people that believe that the laws of a nation doesn't apply to them. They are their own sovereign nation. They're above the laws. The laws don't apply to them. Now, that description that I just told you about a sovereign citizen, is directed at who in the United States? That would be describing police officers across the nation. Because they believe after 6 months of academy training, they know everything there is to know about the law. Police, law enforcement are sovereign citizens because they believe the laws do not apply to them. They believe they are above the law because they have a badge. We are the ones that empower them to do what they do, and then they use that to brutalize black people specifically. Sovereign citizens. Go look it up if you don't know what it is. Understand what it is. So Joe Biden shows up, and after all, we are now in election season. After all the polls and people have been showing them that they are leaking black support, they are now kind of worried. Because if you've been watching me on the Demetra K show, as well as my own show, we have been telling everybody the numbers. The Democrats can't win an election if they lose more than 20% of the black vote. Why is 20% so crucial to the Democrats? Because we give 96% of our vote unilaterally, monolithically, to the Democratic Party. That's factual. Yes, black men have been catering off of the Democratic Party, but in the last election, black women supported the Democratic Party because they've been told that they are the backbone of the Democratic Party. I think they voted at 94% or something like that, 93%, don't quote me, but something like that, give or take 5%. And black people were about 3% behind them. Black people in the United States are the only group of people that monolithically give our vote all to the Democratic Party. We're the only group that does that. That's why we don't talk about Republicans. There's no need to talk about the Republican Party because we unilaterally do not vote Republican. So let's round it up. Let's say black people in general give 100% of their vote to the Democratic Party. 50% of white people are split 50-50 between Democrat and Republican in general. Hispanics, 60% would give their vote in general to the Republican Party, 40% to the Democrats. Asians are pretty much 45% to each party, maybe, whatever, whatever. They support Democratic policies, they just don't vote Democrat in general. Okay. If the Democrats lose 20% of the black vote, which would put them down to about 80% of black support, they can't win the election. That's how crucial the black vote is. Malcolm X even talked about that in the 1960s. Black people are the deciding factor of who gets in the office. Even in the last election, it took the black vote to get Joe Biden into the White House. So we're the deciding factor. But yet we got him into office, and then what was the first thing the Boulé, the fraternities, and all these ignorant Negroes were talking about? Well, he just got into office, and there's not much he can do. I get tired of the lame excuses that the ignorant, no caring Negroes keep giving. Number one, he just got into office. Number two, well, the Republicans are blocking him. You dumb Negro. Joe Biden, just like Obama, came into office with the House, the Senate, and the presidency. 2 years worth of doing whatever you want. And you do it within the 2 years, but then when it comes for black people's issues, that's always pushed to the side, and then you lose the House, then you blame the Republicans for obstruction. That's the playbook. That's how you do it. Because when Joe Biden got into office, if you look at it within the first 45 days of in office, everybody that wanted something got something. The Asians got a crime bill. LGBTQ got their stuff. Illegals got their stuff. Dreamers got their stuff. The military industrial complex got their stuff. Everybody got a bag. And then when it was finally time that they couldn't use any more excuses to get to the black agenda, he couldn't do it. Everything that, if you go look it up, everything that Joe Biden wanted to do in his administration, he did it within the first 45 days. That's factual. That's factual, people. So how are you going to sit in my face and tell me I am delusional? How can you tell me I'm delusional? For almost 2 years now, this man has basically sitting in basements and going to meetings and just traveling around doing absolutely nothing, photo ops, because everything that he needed to do on the Democratic agenda, he did. I want you guys to realize this, and this is why I'm doing this podcast, because you got a lot of ignorant Negroes that are going to run around here talking about, well, lesser evil, the lesser evil. If you're a true Christian, you don't vote for evil no matter what it is. So it's better that you sit it out. So I'm not telling you to vote Republican. That isn't what the new black media is telling you guys. We're not telling you to vote Republican. It is best that you sit this out if you are not going to do a punitive vote against the Democratic Party by voting for a Republican, because that's what I'm going to do. I am voting for the Republican nominee no matter who it was. I was really backing Chris Christie. He recently dropped out of the election last night. So whoever the Republican nominee is, that's who I'm voting for. But in the words of the great Republican president, Ronald Reagan, you have to look at yourself, and this, and I quote, it's a very simple question. Are you off better today than you were 4 years ago? If you say yes, hey, vote Democrat. But if you're saying no, vote independent or sit this thing out. Because both parties uphold white supremacy, as we keep telling you guys. Both parties uphold white supremacy. There's just no doubt about that. Do you go into a store to look for an item and the item is not there, then you leave your money and you walk out? No, you don't do that. What you do is you wait until the item gets there or there's something that you want to buy. It's the same thing when it comes to elections. Your vote is for sale. If neither of these candidates is for you, as a black person, it is best that you sit it out. Oh, but if Trump gets in there, it's going to be bad. You already survived 4 years of Trump. Do you guys realize? Because when Trump got into office, you were so afraid of the boogeyman, the orange boogeyman, Donald Trump, that you guys went out and did for self. It took Donald Trump to scare you to go out there and do for self. We won't give Donald Trump any credit for the things that he wanted to do. Why is it that the HBCUs have to go to the Democratic presidents and even some of the Republican ones every year to beg for money? To beg for funding. But they go to Donald Trump and he says, why do you guys keep coming to me every year? We'll give you $10 billion to get out of my face. You ain't got to come back here for another 10 or 12 years, whatever it is, 10, 20 years. Here's your money. Get the hell out of my face. But we know in the black community, them Boulay niggas are going to steal all that money. Deion Sanders exposed that from Jackson State. But here's the fear I want you guys to understand. The fear is this. When a president first gets in office, just what Joe Biden did, you got to do your agenda in that first term. Whatever you're going to do has to be done in the first term. Because the game, gentlemen and ladies, is to give the power to the next group. Republicans and Democrats work together. Do not think that they don't. They don't care who is in power. Example. They unilaterally voted for the Asian crime bill, anti-Asian hate bill. Unilaterally. Republicans and Democrats unilaterally approved it and the president signed it. They work together for the agendas that they both agree on. Don't get fooled by this us versus them mentality. It's bullshit. Anything a president does, this is why Republicans are so good at what they do. When they get into office, they push their agenda immediately. Immediately. Because they know they have the momentum, they have the political capital to do it, the mandate to do it. Black people, everything that Joe Biden promised you, he never delivered, not one thing. Did he not say, if you give us Georgia and you get Ossoff and Warnock in the office, those stimulus checks are going out the next day? Did you get the $2,000 stimulus? No, he stiffed you by 600. Not one promise was kept. So my point is this: when a president comes into office, the first term is the term that he has to get his agenda through. Obama did it, Biden did it. And notice when it came time to address the black stuff, oh, I'm being obstructed. All the excuses in the world. Oh, I'm being obstructed. It's the Republicans. They're obstructing me. This is that. The student loan debt or whatever else that was going on in the Biden administration was stopped by two Democratic senators that were Republicans posing as Democrats. That's the excuses. These are the agents. It is to keep black people at the bottom of this economic system. And you can fool yourself all you want. Fool yourself all you want. We are now a permanent underclass. That is factual. 70%, in my opinion, because my opinion is based on my perspective and my reality and what I see going on around me. Over 60% of my reality, LA, homeless is black people. 50% of black people across the nation compromise the homeless population. How is that possible if the census says we're only 14% of the population? That tells me there is a systematic genocide by the government of the United States to disenfranchise and enslave black people and take away wealth. Would you agree? Would you agree? Could I get a hand clap for Or my lying eyes are continually to lie to me. LA now is less than 6% black. There's a mass exodus of black people out of California. How the hell do you build a $6 billion football stadium in the heart and the neighborhood of black people who can't even afford one ticket to go to a game? Why didn't they build the stadium next to Beverly Hills where the rich white people are, or down in Orange County where the rich people are? Why didn't they do that? No, they put the damn stadium in the heart of black community. And you guys are sitting here telling me I am paranoid. What I'm seeing and my reality is not what I'm seeing. 70% of black people are not making it. And again, I'm not saying 70% of black people are poor. Listen to what I'm saying. 70% of the 14% of the black population, and it's really not 14% according to the census. I know it's more than that. We have to be at least 25 to 26% of the population. But they do that so that it reduces our resources even more. You can't be 14% of a population for over 60 years. But the Democrats push abortion and homosexuality and the destruction of the nuclear family in the black community. That's a sanctioned homicide of a people. I mean, people, wake Hello, McFly. Wake up. The numbers are not adding up. So my point is this, and I'm going to make it really simple for everybody to understand this. When a president is reelected, he could promise you everything in the world. And we saw that with Barack Obama. Remember when he was running for reelection, he kept saying, "Hey, I hear you. I know I should have done this. I know I should have done that. But if you reelect me and I get into the second term, I'm going to do this." Do you guys realize in 2008, a third of black wealth was taken by the banks? And Barack Obama, instead of incentivizing American people who were predatorily preyed upon by the banks, instead of making us right, he did absolutely nothing and bailed out the banks. And our dumbasses gave him a second term. What did a Barack Obama do in a second term for black people that he did in the first term? Absolutely nothing. Because guess what? He cannot run for a second term. So anything that these people promise you means nothing at this point. A Joe Biden re-election is the doom of black people. If you think that we're being assaulted now, you wait till a second term gets here. You better believe it. You better believe it. If you don't believe what you're seeing now, you wait till a second term. Any promises he has and will make won't mean anything in a second term. If you thought you got ignored from in the first term, wait till the second term. Wait till that second term. And then it's going to be, "Oh, we lost the elections. The Republicans are now in control, so there's not much we could do. Sorry, black people. Oh my God." I was talking to some people, and they did not even realize by executive order, Joe Biden legalized 500,000 migrants to get not a path to citizenship, but legalize them to work here in the United States. 500,000 illegal people that came here illegally, broke our laws. This is the man that wrote the 1995 crime bill. Why isn't the federal government enforcing the law? If that was black people to break laws, we would be in jail wholeheartedly, no questions asked, thrown away, 85% of the job done. Immigration is a federal responsibility. Protection of the border is a federal responsibility. The 1995 crime bill has not been repealed. Why is Joe Biden not enforcing a bill that he authored, but he uses it against American citizens? People, we're in the fourth quarter, black people. It's the fourth quarter. We're down by 8 points. We have to score a touchdown plus the 2-point conversion just to stay in the game at this point. You would be an absolute fool to vote for Joe Biden again. Under Donald Trump, you were so scared for your life that you went and created your own businesses. You realized, hey, we got to get back in our communities and stick together. I actually think another Trump term ain't gonna affect the black community. When you're at the bottom, you have nothing to lose. So let me get back to what I mean by 70% of black people ain't making it. I'm not saying 70% of black people are poor. I'm saying they're not making it. When you are below the poverty line, at the poverty line, and just above it, two-thirds of what I just said means you're not poor. You're not done. If you're at the poverty line and just above it, that means you're barely making it. But a third of us ain't making it, period. But with today's economy and the inflation, those three elements of our community, with the inflation and prices going up, if you're at the poverty line, now you're going below it. If you're just above the poverty line, you're getting lower. That's what I'm meaning. It affects us no matter what we do. We hover around the poverty line. If the poverty line is, I guess, what do they say, $24,000 in the United States? And the average black person in the United States, black man, makes $43,000. So you mean to tell me half of what a black man makes annually, half would make him impoverished at the poverty line? So you mean to tell me that that black man has to live off of another $20,000 just to keep his head above water? That's a family. That's a family. That's not a single man. That's a family. Ladies and gentlemen, another term, another Joe Biden term is disastrous for the black community. We are under assault by the Democratic Party. All of these black representatives, the CBC and stuff. Isn't it funny that when it's election time, and I know there's a meme on it, and everybody always laughs about it, like, because it is funny that as soon as they get our vote, then they throw us out of the car, and then they want to come back every 2 years, every 2 and 4 years, they want to come back and beg us for our vote. That's what he just did in South Carolina. Wake up. Remember in school days? Wake How much more suffering do you think you can handle in the modern age? Genetically modified food, rent is going up, all kinds of stuff is happening. Why is it that we are at the bottom of everything under a democratic regime for over 80 years? Over 80 years. We're not just talking about the 60s. We're talking about since FDR, World War II. Why are we going backwards? Look at the policies the Democrat Party does. How they compete men against women in our own communities. They actually got our women thinking they're the backbone of the Democratic Party. Well, ladies, if you are the damn backbone of the Democratic Party, why are we suffering? Where is your nurturing element of being a woman? Where's your empathy? Is anybody thinking of the children, the next generation? But I'm crazy. Oh, I'm a Trump supporter. Oh, you must be a Republican. Woo, you guys. It is getting hot in here. I need to take off all of my clothes. It's that bad, you guys. It is that bad. Now, am I going to be okay? I'm on a fixed income. I'm retired. I'm on a fixed income. All of this stuff affects me. So, what are the solutions, Donovan? What are the solutions? Black people. I do not think it would be a bad thing that Donald Trump comes back into power. What could possibly happen to us? We've already survived 4 years of Donald Trump. When you're at the bottom, like my mom always says, The only way to go is up. In 2008, more than half of black people didn't even realize we were, well, not 2008, I'm sorry. When a recession happened in the early 90s or whatever it was, most black people didn't even realize it happened unless you had something. We are not that far from basically having no wealth. Do you guys realize that the Caucasian group of people, or of the baby boomer generation, they are slated to transfer $13 trillion worth of wealth to their children? It is estimated in the black community it's 3 trillion. Where is this disparity in wealth? And it's just getting bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. Your perspective is your reality. When you walk out your door, that is your reality. That is what you should be measuring, what is going on in the world. When you look in your community, and I know black people, we don't have a community anymore, but when you look out in your community and you don't see other people like you, there's a problem. There's a big problem. The solution is, black people, we have to start building our communities back. The solution, black people, is black men and women need to stick together. The solution is we got to get back into our traditional roles, ladies and gentlemen. Women are stressed out. Ladies, there's been a report that has come out where now you guys are dying and having medical problems as if you guys were men back in the 70s. You want to know why? Because you're not built to be out there and stressed out in a world where men are supposed to dominate. You have a problem in society when you tell young children, boys and girls, that they're equal. That's such bullshit. When you get a job, do you get the same pay as the CEO when you first get the job? So where's the equality? So you mean to tell me when I get to a job, I should immediately demand equal pay? Make it make sense. This is what we're talking about, delusion. The solution in the black community is we need to get back into our gender roles. I'm not saying women should not get an education. I'm not saying if a woman wants to work, she should be denied work. That is not what I'm saying. What I am saying is men should work in their traditional aspect. If a woman doesn't want to work and she wants to be a homemaker, that is no shame. To me, that's the hardest job in the world to do. And to me, it is the most honored job. It's the most honored job because you're teaching the next generation. You're teaching the next generation. Women cannot do what men do, and men cannot do what women do. It's just that cut and dry, people. Gender equality, it's got to stop. This feminism has ruined women in the Western world. It's ruined it. Ladies, you can't have it both ways. You can't be a modern woman and then want to be treated traditionally. You can't have it both ways. If that was the case, why can't I, as a man, be married and have a girlfriend on the side? Oh, no, how dare you do that? No, that's impossible. No, that's not right. Make it make sense. Oh, boy. Boy, boy, boy. Ladies and gentlemen, a second Biden administration is nothing to black people. We didn't get nothing the first term. Everybody else got a bag off of us, as they usually do. You think you're going to reelect this man and you're going to get something? You had a black skin president, and I'm saying black skin because his lineage isn't the same as Ados, and you didn't get nothing there. But we got universal health care. We got no. Specific. Every other group got specific things. The Dreamers got their stuff. The Asian Pacificers got their stuff. Why is it that when it comes to black people, we can't seem to get anything? And what we want is cut the damn check, reparations. But we got these old niggas running around here, Maxine Waters, Karen Bass, Barbara Lee, Sheila Jackson Lee, that do nothing for their community. You know, the sad thing is these are women. These women are mothers. How do you not have empathy for your own people? You do absolutely nothing. We got to stop that. If a person that we elect to serve us does not produce anything for our community, they don't need to be reelected. And in my opinion, Joe Biden should not be reelected. How do you get, number one, I never understood how people could elect, black people elect a known racist as Joe Biden. A man that wrote the crime bill and every adverse bill against black people hung out and was mentored by Dixiecrats that were racist. And yet his son and his daughter broke crimes and yet hasn't served one day in jail based on the 1995 crime bill that he wrote. Isn't that amazing? His kids did not suffer, but how many black people suffered in the 90s due to the crack epidemic that we know that the government systematically put in the black neighborhoods? Ladies and gentlemen, just like my compadre, Demetra K says, you got to first be acknowledged as a human being before you even worry about civil rights. They don't even acknowledge us as human beings. We got to be acknowledged as human beings before we could even worry about civil rights. They give us the illusion of inclusion, but they want us to feel sorry for the Jews and what happened to them, but we can't feel sorry for ourselves that for the genocide that is continuing to happen to us right here in the United States. I get so upset. I get so upset. Ladies and gentlemen, wake up. It's just so crazy. It's just so sad, very sad, how we do what we do. But a lot of the new black media, we have been talking and telling you guys this for years now. And it's funny when we started talking about this and like actually highlighting this on YouTube and X and all of these platforms, we were laughed at. Oh, you guys don't know what you're talking about, whatever, whatever, whatever. But now people are seeing it. A direct attack upon the black community by the Democratic Party. The very people that unilaterally gives 96% of their vote to a party is being attacked by that very party. And our black elders see what is going on and say and do nothing about it. We can't even turn to our elders for advice. Because I've told you guys before, nobody benefited and should benefit from the civil rights movement other than the people who fought it. But now this is our fight, and we have to make a stand. Donald Trump said, "What do you got to lose? Why is these people panicking? You're at the bottom. You're at the bottom. What are you panicking about? You can't get any lower. You are lower than the curb in this country, black people, and everybody around the world sees it. That's why they come here and they're elevated above us. You can deny it and shake your head all you want, but you know deep down in places you don't want to talk about that it's true. That it's true. Of almost a million veterans, let's forget about black and white or black in America. A million veterans are homeless in the United States, and our elected servants can't seem to solve veteran homelessness, which is a national disgrace. But you can let people come here, break our laws, and you put them up in hotels. Black people have fundamentally lost one third of their wealth under the Obama administration, and he bailed out the damn banks, knowing his people suffered the most by predatory lending. And he bailed the banks out. But then again, we're not his people. Get it right, everybody. But I'm paranoid. Donovan's paranoid. Oh my God, he's paranoid. No. My reality is what I see outside my front door. What's your reality? What is your reality? Where is the upscale Black community that we can call like Beverly Hills? And I know people say, well, in Baltimore, or I'm sorry, in the DMV area, what's the name of it? What's the name of the high affluent Black community? Right now, when you say Beverly Hills, anywhere in the United States, everybody knows what you're talking about. High rich people. You say Calabasas in California, high area community. All the stars live in that area. Even Maxine Waters, she lives in that area, even though she's not supposed to. Where is the high-end Black community where Black people are congregated and living in the United States? Well, it's somewhere in the DMV area. Stop it. If a majority of people cannot name it that don't live in the DMV area, it doesn't exist. It doesn't exist. Stop it. Donovan, you're just paranoid. Yeah, I know. Ladies and gentlemen, a second Biden term would be disastrous for Black people. Just want you to remember that. Hey, you guys, do not forget to check me out and my compadre, Demetri K, on The Demetri K Show on Sundays, 3 p.m. Central Standard Time. Please check us out over there. It's one of the few shows where we are the co-hosts, where you guys are the co-hosts, and we get interaction. She was one of the first shows that actually started doing this. Do not forget to check out my fellow brother, Philip Scott. The Philip Scott Podcast, a lot of great information. And again, do not forget to check out the African Diaspora News Channel. Go to African Diaspora News.org. You can sign up there as well. Please, we are actually going to be pushing this app so that we can do what it is we want to do. Vicky Dillard, again, Wangel, a lot of great people there. Demetri K, a lot of good content there. Also, do not forget to check out the Donovan Sadiq Show and Rehab Radio. This is Rehab Radio that we're on right now. I'm the Recovering Democrat. I'm also known as Recovering Democrat. A lot of you guys are now in recovery. You guys are in recovery. And you guys are going to be known as recovering Democrats too. Because just like a bad addiction, you know that continually to vote for the Democratic Party is bad for you, it's bad for your community. So do not stop here and say that you're not in recovery, because you are. I want to thank you guys for joining me today. Do not forget, also, Demetri K and I, we also talk on Tuesdays. Look for us on the After Diaspora, but the New Black Media. Thank you, New Black Media, for waking a lot of people up. And again, this isn't about our seniors. This isn't about our elders. We're not attacking our elders, because there's a lot of elders out there that get it. They understand what's going on. But we need those elders that are in positions of power to wake up. This is where we're at, you guys. You guys be safe. Happy New Year. And we'll be talking more again as we continue to wake you guys up as these elections keep coming down. It's very cold in California right now, you guys. Saying to myself, I gotta be with you.